doing the main histology duties, which I'm not complaining because I used to do a lot of things manually, and I used to be a one-woman show, so I'm not complaining at all. But for some newer histotechs, I want you guys to know that you're watching someone who has ran a lab. And I filed blocks, I've did the processor, I've dumped xylene, I've cleaned the processor. And we're not talking about some nice pylorises. I'm talking about some old ass tissue techs. Making sure as a lab tech that you are practicing confidence. You do not need that recognition that you may think that you may need. Not comparing yourselves. If you guys have been watching me for, you know, some time now, you guys know my main major key is never compare yourself to other histotechs. Also to just know that you will come into contact with other histotechs who may not be on the same wavelength as you. You guys know on my channel, I have not really said anything negative about, you know, the field of histology, but I want to make sure that I create a safe place for you guys, especially as new histotechs and especially as new travelers, because these are the things that, you know, we don't hear enough of here on YouTube, and I want to make sure you guys have a safe space because it's already scary going into a profession which you probably had no idea or clue about, just like myself. So I do not want to create any type of anxiety, any type of fear, any type of nervousness, because those are the things that you're going to get when it comes to the ASCP. Those are the things that you're going to get when it comes to school. Those are the things that you're going to get whenever you get your first histology job, when you're going your first interview, whenever you are working with new people. So I do not need to add any type of anxiety to your into you building your histology career. But what I do want to say is you will come in contact with other histologists who may not be on the same wavelength as you, who probably are a little bit older and stuck in their ways, who, you know, you may get micromanagement. You may get, you know, some people who are a little bit lazier. You may get people who are just like, oh, they always go above and beyond. So it's going to be a mixture of all of those type of people, just like in any profession and just like in any job. But what I want you guys to focus on in the lab is making sure that you are focusing on your personal development and, you know, just proving those things to yourself, making sure that you are learning as much as you can, making sure you are also, once you learn something, you give that back and you teach that, and you train someone. If you have the opportunity of training, you make sure that you train someone as the way that you would want to be trained. If you didn't get great training whenever you came onto the floor, if you didn't get great training as a new histotech, take those things with you, and one day when you are, you know, confident in your role, you will be training other people. And when you do get that opportunity, you can basically train them a totally different way, still the same protocol, but just in a way that it would ease any type of anxiety or fear. Because I worked with a lot of people right now in my 5.5 years of being a tech, and I've trained a lot of people. And when I say a lot of people, I would say at least, you know, 20 people I probably trained. And whether if it was just from the smallest things. But I just want to let you guys know that it definitely holds weight. It definitely leaves a lasting impression. It definitely makes a new histotech feels good. Feels good. It definitely lets a new histotech feel good about themselves when they know that they can come to you with any questions, any concerns. You know, you don't feel like that you're bugging them and whatever the issue may be. And I always tell you guys that you need to ask questions. Hold on to a block if you're not comfortable with it. Hold on to, you know, email someone, go get another histotech, get your colleagues, whatever that it may be, instead of you just, you know, making a decision and then something goes wrong with patient care, because that's all of our fear, right? So just want to make sure that you are confident in what you do, and make sure that you are taking your time. Recognition won't always come, but just know whenever you leave for the day, that is your personal recognition and your personal development. And just make sure that you speak up if things may not be working out for you, if you speak up, if things may still seem unclear, and also speak up, you know, when you're ready to probably do something else in the lab and learn something different and not really care what the next person is going to think, but focus on you and your personal growth. All right, guys, I think that's it for some things that you should consider or think about and take with you in your first year as a histotech. If you guys found value out of this content, please let YouTube know by thumbs up-ing, by giving my video a thumbs up. Let YouTube know that you enjoy my content, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.